Good morning students, I Asad Patel welcome you to study from home. Today I am going to explain you about chapter number 2 inside our earth for class 7 subject geography. Students, in a previous classes I explained you about inside our earth, interior of earth, crust, like crust, metal and core, right? These are the some layer of the earth, three major layer in fact of the earth, as well as I explained you about rock and minerals, types of rocks like igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks, right? Today I am going to explain you about igneous rocks, types of igneous rocks, how igneous rocks are formed and some example of igneous rocks. Now, formation of igneous rocks. Igneous rocks form when magma molten rock cool and crystallize either at volcanoes on the surface of the earth or while the melted rock is still inside the crust. All magma develop underground in the lower crust or upper mantle because of the intense heat there, right? So this is how igneous rocks formed. Now, how many types of igneous rocks? There are two types of igneous rocks. There are intrusive rocks and extrusive rocks. Now, what is an intrusive igneous rock? How it is formed? Okay, so intrusive igneous rock is formed when the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth, earth's crust. Granite, for example, granite. Since they cool down slowly, they form a large grains, granite. Grinding stone used to prepare powder of the spices and grain are made of a granite, right? So this granite is used in construction as well as used for a powder, right? Now our second types of igneous rock is extrusive igneous rock. Now it is formed from molten magma coming from the interior of the earth, means the molten magma come out on the surface of earth and it become a cool down, okay? It rapidly cools down and become a solid. They have very fine grind structure, okay? For example, basalt. The Deccan Plateau is an example of basalt rock. Now again, intrusive igneous rock, sometimes the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth's crust. Solid rocks so form are called intrusive igneous rocks. Here I have some photograph for your information. Here I have some examples of intrusive igneous rocks: pegmatite, granite, diorite and gabbro. All these are the example of intrusive igneous rocks. Now I am going to tell you about extrusive igneous rocks. As I told you that when this molten lava come on the earth's surface and it's rapidly cooled down and become a solid, it forms a extrusive igneous rocks. So student, let me make it very short for you that whatever the process take place inside the earth that form a intrusive igneous rock, and whatever the process take place on the surface of the earth is called extrusive process, and it is from extrusive igneous rocks. Now these are some example of extrusive igneous rocks, that is obsidian, pumica, rhyolite, andesite, basalt and scoria. So these are the some example of extrusive as well as intrusive igneous rocks, right? I already explained you formation of igneous rocks, types of igneous rocks, but for your information let me summarize this topic that
I explain you about igneous rock. Types of igneous rock is extrusive igneous rock and intrusive igneous rock. How they are being formed and what are the example of these rocks. So this is all for today. In next chapter, I am going to explain you about sedimentary rocks as well as metamorphic rock and formation of these two rocks. Thank you and have a nice day.